met earlier. I thank the organizers for giving me this opportunity to talk about some basics about fistula in ano. Fistula in ano per se is a very common condition which brings about a lot of discomfort to the person who is suffering from a fistula's tract. A fistula is basically an abnormal connection between the exterior and a hollow viscus, or between two hollow viscera. There could be, what we are going to talk about is a fistula in ano, that is a fistula which connects the perianal region to the anal canal. That is what we are going to talk about. If we are seeing the person in this position and this is the anal opening, the fistula is an external opening which is seen by the patient and by the examining doctor, and this is the anal canal. So it connects to the anal canal. So that satisfies the definition. Yeah, I'll be showing it to you subsequently. Fistula is an abnormal connection between the exterior and a hollow viscus. Now the anus is a hollow viscus, or between two hollow viscera. Now there could be a fistula between the stomach and the jejunum, a fistula between the gallbladder and the duodenum. So all these are other various instances. What we are going to talk about is a fistula in ano. So fistula in ano is a tract which is lined by granulation tissue and that connects deeply in the anal canal, or if it is the higher type, it will connect to the rectum and superficially on the skin around the anus. Now, what are the causes of the fistula? It could be because of some inflammatory disease that the patient is suffering from, like ulcerative colitis, Crohn's disease, tuberculosis, or neoplastic causes like cancer of the rectum or anal canal. It is also more commonly seen because of infection of the anal crypts. The incidence is common and may be simple or complex. By simple or complex we mean that the tract may be a singular tract like that, or the tract maybe more of the branching type, and therefore a complex one becomes more difficult to treat and the results are not that satisfying. Again, it is classified into the high variety or the low depending on where the tract passes above or below the anorectal ring. What is the pathology? The inflammation causes ulceration, penetration of the ulcer through all the layers of the viscus, involving the adjacent hollow viscus in the ulceration, and the connection is established. Or the ulceration may involve the abdominal wall, leading to opening of the hollow viscus to the outside. Fistula in ano usually starts as a perianal abscess. Now these are the two legs of the patient. This is the anal opening. It starts as a perianal abscess. the person experiences a lot of pain in the gluteal region. And that is how it starts, the perianal abscess. The abscess bursts open and it starts discharging pus. A tract between the perianal skin and the anal canal is established. Because this is basically a very closed cavity, and the abscess, the pus which is present in the abscess, goes on collecting, and when it opens to the exterior as well as it opens to the hollow viscus, that is the anal canal. The infection and the suppuration commonly starts in an anal gland, which is found at the dentate line of the anal canal, and it spreads to the perianal region. What are the clinical features? How does the patient manifest? In order of prevalence, there will be a perianal discharge, there will be pain, swelling, bleeding, because as we said, the fistulous tract is lined by the granulation tissue, and that granulation tissue has a tendency to bleed. Diarrhea, sometimes the patient has diarrhea, skin excoriation, and an external opening. What are the investigations that need to be done? One is an examination where the patient is made to lie down on the left side in the left lateral position and examined in that particular position becomes easier to determine from where the discharge is coming. A digital examination, that is a per-rectal examination, is done. Proctoscopy, it is a small scope which is introduced through the anal through the anus into the anal canal, and sometimes one has to do a radiography in order to delineate the fistulous tract, and other routine investigations like hemoglobin, total count, differential count, and ESR. ESR is an indicator, it's increased, but it is not a positive diagnostic tool, but more often we see that in tuberculosis patient the ESR is raised. And what are the differential diagnoses? As we said earlier, ulcerative colitis, Crohn's disease of the anal canal and rectum, anal tuberculosis, actinomycosis, cancer of the rectum, and plain infection. Complications, as we saw earlier, branching of the fistulous tract. And if there are multiple openings of the fistula, then what we call, there will be pus discharge from several openings. And therefore, it is called as a water can perineum. The treatment is, ordinary fistulae need laying the tract open and formation of a groove which will heal from the bottom of the groove. If the fistula is over here, what is done is the entire tract is laid open. And the wound which results because of the opening of the tract heals by granulation tissue. So the person will be required to undergo dressings for at least about 10 days to about 2 weeks. Occasionally, a high fistula may need a two-stage operation, one stage of laying open as far as possible and then inserting a seton suture. That is, that suture is negotiated through the tract and it is tied externally. Gradually, the seton string is tightened and that cuts through the fistulous tract. Second stage, laying the rest of the tract open. Now, this is what we are trying to see, evolution of a fistula. This is the perianal region where an abscess has formed. And this abscess keeps on burrowing itself. The infection has started from the anal crypt over here. It burrows itself and it forms a tract. This is to show the connection between the external opening and the internal opening of the fistula's tract. It's a low fistula in ano. A fistula in ano is diagnosed when a probe has been passed between the opening on the skin surface and the interior opening. This is also a picture showing a perirectal abscess. This is the perirectal abscess which you see. This is the normal side of the buttock and this is the inflamed area in the other buttock. If you can appreciate, this is the external opening of the fistula. This is the external opening of the other considerations are past medical history. Important points in the history that may suggest a complex fistula include the following, that is the inflammatory bowel disease like Crohn's disease, ulcerative colitis, diverticulitis, previous radiation therapy for prostate or rectal cancer, tuberculosis, steroid therapy and HIV infection. Now the classification system of the fistula, the Parkes classification system defines four types of fistula in ano that result from the cryptoglandular infections. Intersphincteric. Intersphincteric, the common is the via the internal sphincter to the intersphincteric space and then to the perineum. 70% of all anal fistula fall in this category of intersphincteric area. Other possible tracts are no perianal opening, high blind tract, high tract to lower rectum or pelvis. Transsphincteric, that is it goes across the sphincter. Common cause is low via internal and external sphincters into the ischiorectal fossa and then to the perineum. 25% of all anal fistulae belong to this category, transsphincteric. Other possible tracts are high tract with perineal opening and high blind tract. Then you have the suprasphincteric. Common causes via the intersphincteric space superiorly to above. There is a muscle